Saint-Pierre, capital of Saint-Pierre-Miquelon, population 6,000, on a rare sunny day looking picturesque, but looks can be deceiving. Saint-Pierre's economic future is in doubt. The island's main private employer, the fish factory, closed earlier this year. The economy is driven by subsidized French government jobs, and locals fear the downturn may force France to cut back. And without greater access to the mineral riches that lie on the seabed, the island's economy could be in deeper trouble.
There is no real economy here, per se, so you know we need to find a new economy for the islands.
The claim to increase territorial rights, the seabed they view as a potential lifeline, is the talk of Saint-Pierre.
The Newfoundland, they figure it's all theirs, but I think they could share the wealth a bit.
It would be better, you know. We get some money with work and not money from the French government.
France already has access to a corridor, giving it rights to underwater resources like fish and oil. The claim, launched at the United Nations, seeks to extend that corridor far beyond Canadian waters. The point is, Saint-Pierre-et-Miquelon is not trying to be like France, nor is it a French-speaking province like Quebec. This is French soil, part of the European Union. And look, it's only a handful of kilometres off the Canadian coast. The Canadians reject the French claim, fearing their own economy will lose out if the UN finds in France's favour.
We're really conscious, of course, and sometimes nervous when it comes to jurisdictional talk about who owns the resources off our coast.
Canada has until 2013 to respond. The people of France and Saint-Pierre hope that they eventually win their claim, fearing that a rejection might be a sign their island way of life is on the way out. John Terrett, Al Jazeera, Saint-Pierre-et-Miquelon, off the coast of Canada.